Zeit. Aber wie auch, wenn niemand rausschaut, lieber auf der Couch mit Frauentausch oder Bauer sucht Frau. Und ja, natürlich nur ironisch, Prognose nebenbei. Aber im Vergleich mit den Opfern, da ist das eigene Leben schon geil. Ein Hund weiß nicht, wer er bellt, und alles ist gut, solange die auf RTL noch bisschen dümmer sind als du. Und ich schieße in die Luft.
Welcome to today's show. This is the International Experience with Tandika, and you're listening to some music from Luxembourg, compliments of our guest today, Diane. I'm so excited to have her.
Yay, I'm so excited to be here.
Diane is a very dear friend of mine. We've known each other since Keene University days.
Yes.
And we're just going to have a nice chit-chat about her international experience and about her culture. So thank you for joining us and enjoy the music. Streaming live on WPUB.org. This is the International Experience, and I'm your host, Tandika. We stream every Tuesday from 12 to 1 p.m. here in downtown Manhattan at Pace University WPUB Radio. We're so excited to have you every week on our show. We feature a different international student, and we focus on a different culture. And today is no different. Today we're going all the way to Luxembourg, and you're listening to some music from Luxembourg. And Diane will tell us some more about this music. I'm not going to even attempt to pretend that I even know what they're talking about.
So this is actually a German song, because as I mentioned to you before, Luxembourgish music is really difficult to find. Especially
but you speak
Spotify.
German in Luxembourg.
Yes, we do. We speak actually three languages in Luxembourg. So okay. It's Luxembourgish, German, and French. So French is the administrative language. German, I guess, can be compared to Luxembourgish. They're very close. Everybody speaks German, French, and Luxembourgish. It's a thing. It's a thing. And most people here are like, wow, you speak so many languages. But over there, it's just the norm.
Yeah.
So you basically have to. And yeah, this is a German song. We play lots of German music in Luxembourg. We play French music. And there's a couple of Luxembourgish hits that I put in the playlist. But yeah, we'll see if
what is he saying, though? All I can hear is bang, bang, bang.
He's basically saying that he is shooting into the air. That's why he's like bang, bang, bang. So
I figured there was some shooting involved.
Some shooting involved, yeah. So it's a fun song. I really like it.
All right.
We'll see if you like it.
If you're now joining us, we have our guest today, Diane. Diane is from Luxembourg. And Diane, Luxembourg has something in common with Guyana in the sense that it's a very small country.
It's tiny, yeah.
So tell us about the country of Luxembourg and what it was like growing up there for you.
Okay, so basically, just to refer to the size of it, it can be compared to the size of Rhode Island. I just found that on Google, so just so you can picture it a little bit better. You can barely see it on the map. It's so, so small. It's between Belgium, France, and Germany. It has a population of 500,000 people, which is really crazy when you think about it, because New York City alone has 8 million people.
Yeah.
So it's like, wow. I think it's like 1,000 square miles or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really small. A third of it is just forest.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up in Luxembourg City, so the capital, which is also called Luxembourg, very creative. Honestly, I love growing up there. I love the diversity. I love that everyone is speaking so many languages. we have a very big Portuguese population. I think about half of the people working there, so the workforce, they're actually commuting in from Germany, France, and Belgium every
Wow,
day.
It's that close?
It's very close. Like,
how close is the drive? Like,
it's like 5 minutes, depending on where, of course, you live. Like,
are you serious?
On the border, yeah. It's insane that close. It's a mess, obviously, in the mornings and like rush hour, you know. But yeah, that's just the way it is. My parents, they are not Luxembourgish themselves. They are. So my dad is from France. My mom is from Germany, and they both came to Luxembourg when they were really young to work. Because money is good in Luxembourg, so yeah, so that's where they met, and then they just decided to stay there because it's basically in the middle of France and Germany.
Yeah.
And yeah, then I was born, and that's yeah, that's how it worked out for us. And yeah, I really enjoyed growing up with so many languages. It's a little challenging for kids, I guess.
Because, yeah.
I mean,
I find like children pick up languages faster.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. It was quite easy, I guess, because I learned French and German at home. I went to a French nursery, and then suddenly when I went to kindergarten, everybody was speaking Luxembourgish, but it was not a problem. We were just playing with each other, and that's how I learned while playing with other kids. And I don't even remember how it went, but suddenly I just knew Luxembourgish, and yeah, that's how I suddenly knew three languages. And then later on in grade school, we have math in German, and then later on we have everything in French. And yeah, so eventually everybody will learn the languages pretty fast, because it's just, yeah, it's just a norm.
That's
to.
Pretty cool.
Yeah.
So tell us about your journey from Luxembourg to, well, now you're in New York. I know originally when you came, you were in New Jersey, which is how we met.
That's how we met. Yeah.
So tell me about that journey. Like, why did you come here originally, and how did you end up being a student here at FACE?
Yeah. Okay. So I graduated high school in 2013, and I just felt like I had to get out of the little country that I always lived in and wanted to, like, I don't know, I guess experience the big world. And so I decided to be an au pair, which is a babysitter in another family. So you basically live with that family and they pay you to take care of their kids.
Okay.
So I was with that agency, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna go to America. I wasn't even sure that I was gonna come so close to New York. First, I was interviewing with a family in Atlanta, but that didn't work out because of scheduling, I guess. And then I found another family in New Jersey, and I was like, oh, that's so great. It's so close to New York. And
yeah.
I don't know. I just knew New York from, you know, the series and the movies, and I was really excited. And my host family, they told me how close they were, like, located to New York, because New Jersey is huge. So
yeah.
It's like, you know, how long is the commute going to be? But it was just like, I don't know, it's like a 1.5 to 2 hour train ride. So it's not too bad. So I came here to New York during the weekends. Yeah, so I spent a year in New Jersey, basically coming to New York during the weekends to, you know, do stuff, because New Jersey, you don't really have too much stuff
yeah,
to
I
do.
Know.
You know, you live in Jersey, and I mean, it's a good time if you like the suburbs, but, you know, I'm a city girl. I come from a small city, but
yeah,
still a city. So, yeah, I really fell in love with New York. It was really overwhelming in the beginning, though, because, yeah, like I said, coming from a little country, seeing so many people, so many tourists, these huge buildings, it was intense.
Yeah.
But like, eventually I just learned to stay away from these touristic areas like Times Square. Oh, I hate it.
Yes.
You can't walk through it. But yeah, I don't know. I love New York. I love the energy, the atmosphere, the people. It's very raw and real, and either you like it or
you don't. Exactly.
Yes.
I find if you can survive in New York, you can pretty much survive anywhere.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like if you can make it here, you can make it anywhere.
Yeah, it's a tough place.
Yeah,
it is.
It is.
I did live in New York for, like, I think 2 months when I first came.
Mm-hmm.
It was very intense. The commuting back and forth from New York to New Jersey. Well, I'm still doing that now.
I know. And it's hard.
But yeah, it can get very intense. So you came as an au pair.
Yeah.
And you liked it so much, you decided to come back to go to school. So tell us about that journey.
Yes. Oh my gosh. When I told my parents, yeah, I actually want to go back and, you know, study in America. They were like my parents are the most supportive parents ever. I'm so lucky. So they were like, all right, let's try and make this work. So luckily, I am from Luxembourg, and Luxembourg, since we only have one university because we're so small, they help us out financially to go study abroad. Of course, most people, they decide to go to Germany or France, like something close by in Europe.
Yeah.
Not everyone is like, oh, let's go to America because it's so expensive to study there.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I just applied for financial aid, loans, of course, and made my way back to the US to study, and I stayed in Jersey for my undergrad. And honestly, after the first semester, I wanted to go back home.
I can relate.
I'm telling you.
I can relate, Diane.
It's
trust.
It's so hard to, like, I didn't have any friends the first semester.
The culture shock, the disconnect from your family and friends.
Being an au pair in a family who they kind of guide you, you know, and you're like with other au pairs. It was a very different experience from suddenly being a student
alone
with all the American students.
Yeah.
And everybody knew each other already, and I was just there, the new girl. And of course, I made some kind of connections, but like, it was hard. And in that summer, I went back home, and I don't know, I was like, oh, now I have to go back, and I don't really like it. And I just learned to be persistent, because I was like, my parents went through all that trouble now to get me here, and now I'm complaining. So I just wanted to show them and, I guess, prove to myself that I can do it. So I went back, and I got an amazing job that honestly changed my life there. You know, you worked with me there.
I remember when you came for the interview, we were like, I don't know, she's so quiet. We're so loud in this office.
Yes,
is she going to fit
I was
in?
So intimidated. Guys, you were all like, I mean, you were honestly like friends, right? It's not like a work environment. It's just like a good time there. And I was like, oh my gosh, I don't know if I'm going to like fit in. And then I didn't hear back for so long. So I followed up. And then our former boss, she told me, yeah, you got the job. And
shout out to Jerubi, who's in Istanbul right now.
Yes, she's traveling so much.
Yeah.
It's amazing. She's great. Everybody in this office has been so helpful and supporting. And yeah, I think they're part of like why I'm here now, to be honest. You guys, you really built me up. And yeah, I think I've come a long way since then. We all have.
Yeah,
and,
we all were a great support system to each other in our office. Yeah.
Absolutely.
So if you're not joining us, this is The International Experience. I'm your host, Tandika. And today we're chatting with Diane, who is originally from Luxembourg. And she's a dear friend of mine. And we're listening to some of her music, so I want you to enjoy. And then when we come back after this song, we'll talk some more with Diane about her international experience. Enjoy. So someone on live, Diane, is asking, is Luxembourgish closer, the language, is it closer to German or French?
It's definitely closer to German. Some people who don't know either German or Luxembourgish, they may think it's the same.
Mm-hmm.
Luxembourgish, like, they use kind of like some words in French, like from French, but it's definitely closer to German. Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So Kiana, Diane just answered your question there. Is she saying it's a party?
She basically says, here we go for the show. Et c'est parti. So it's French. It's like, and here we go, kind of like that. Yeah.
Okay.
We're getting ready for the show.
We're getting ready for the show. We're getting ready to have a good time.
Oh, yeah.
Diane, someone on live said that they know the song. Saraya, shout out to you and thank you for watching.
Yay!
I want to say good afternoon to everyone listening to Luxembourg, all of Diane's family and friends that are listening to the show. As we continue to chat with Diane, if you are now tuning in, you're listening to The International Experience. I'm your host, Tandika. Every week, we feature a different culture on the show, or we bring someone on the show who works with international students here at PACE, helping to support their journey, good and bad. Mm-hmm. And today we have Diane with us, who is from Luxembourg, and she is sharing with us about her Luxembourg culture, her Luxembourgish.
Luxembourgish culture,
her Luxembourgish culture.
Yes.
And so we're chatting with Diane, and you're listening to some of Diane's music in the background while we chat. So you started as an au pair, mm-hmm. then you did your undergrad at Keene.
Yes.
What did you study at Keene?
Psychology.
And what are you studying now?
Still psychology.
Wow. So a regular genius.
Just a regular, no. Not at all.
Oh, yes, you're a genius. We know. So what do you plan to do when you graduate?
Okay, so since we're international students, we have 1 year to do OPT, so optional practical training, on our student visa. So that's what I'm going to do after my master's, because I didn't do it after my bachelor's, since I wanted to go straight into my mm-hmm. master's. I was worried I was not going to continue studying, so I was mm-hmm. like, I'm just going to pull through. So I'm going to work for a year. I have a couple of things in mind. So I'm studying psychology, but I'm focusing on criminal justice.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
I did remember you did do a criminal justice, or you did intern.
A minor. Oh, yeah, I did intern at Megan's Law. I was working with sex offenders. That was very interesting.
Yeah.
And so coming here, I'm doing general psychology right now because I kind of wanted to keep an open mind and see what else is out there. Mm-hmm. I was very lucky to do an internship at the UN, but through all that, my interest is still criminal justice and psychology. Mm-hmm. So my dream, my goal is to become a forensic psychologist.
Nice.
So after my year of work of gaining experience in that field, I want to do my doctorates. That's my plan for now. We'll see how that goes, because that's a long process, the application and all that. Yeah. So we'll see how that goes, but I definitely want to stay in New York. I love it here. I am so in sync with the city, I guess. I feel at home here. I really do.
And you recently moved to New York.
Yeah, actually just so recently moved here in April.
Yeah, I know.
Yes.
That was an exciting transition. What is the difference between living in New York as opposed to living in Jersey?
It's a culture shock. A regular.
That in itself is a culture
gosh.
Shock.
It was so crazy. Honestly, like coming from Luxembourg to New Jersey, that was already a little crazy because, you know, suburbs, and I come from a city after all. Like everybody's driving everywhere. Like you have to have a car in New Jersey.
Yeah.
Then when I started school in New York, at first I was commuting back and forth from Jersey to PACE, and it was just too long. It was like a 2-hour ride to go and then 2-hour ride back, and it was just too much, and I was always tired. I was like literally a zombie by Friday, so
I can relate.
Yeah.
I'm still doing that commute.
Yeah, I know. You are. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry you have to go through this, but I know you can do it. You're a strong woman. You're going to be fine. So coming to New York to go to school here as well was definitely easier. I live in Brooklyn now. I have like a, I would say, 40-minute commute if things go well.
To PACE? Yeah.
Yeah, if things mm-hmm. go well, I don't know. I'm in Manhattan and like 20 to 30 minutes.
That's
but,
not
you
bad.
Know, you know the subway, rush yeah. hour. It's a big hassle.
You're like my second guest in 2 weeks that have come on the show to talk about the MTA. I hope someone
does.
From the MTA is listening.
Everybody hear our cry, complain, and I take the L train, and the L train is under construction, and during the weekend it doesn't even really go anymore, so we have to take another train. It's a big mess.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm not here to talk about the train, obviously, but it's I feel like why New Yorkers can be rude sometimes, because they're just pissed at the transportation system. But honestly, I'm so happy coming from New Jersey that we have trains that go anywhere and you don't need a car.
Yeah.
Because it's cheaper than buying or leasing or whatever a car and insurance and all that. So I'm very happy with subways. I don't know, it's fine.
Speaking about culture shocks, what was your biggest culture shock coming from Luxembourg to the US in the whole?
My biggest, like I said, to Jersey first, the fact that I couldn't really walk anywhere. There were like no sidewalks. What is that all about?
And where you lived in Jersey at first, that's far.
In the bush.
Like, you lived in the bush.
In the bush.
You not, really did live in the bush,
Diane. It's not Hoboken or anything. There's more to Jersey than just Hoboken or Jersey City.
You really lived suburbs.
I lived in the suburbs. And it's, like, honestly, especially now in the fall, like, it's beautiful. Like, the leaves are so nice and it's a good time and it's quiet, and I'm sure some people love it, but honestly, when I come home at night and there's no lights on the street, there's no people on the street, that's kind of freaky and I don't like it. It's a sleepy town and it's great for kids and families, honestly.
Yeah, it's a nice town to raise a family.
Yeah, for sure. But like for people our age, it's a little dead. So
I like how you said that people our age. You made me feel a little young there, Diane. Thank you. You just made my day.
You know, I consider us the same age, so we're not even thinking about age anymore here. I feel like I meet so many people who are older than me and I'm like, oh really? I didn't even expect that. Okay. It's like it's not about age anymore now. So we all look young.
It's about being able to connect. Exactly. What do you miss most about Luxembourg?
My family.
100%. And your dogs.
Oh, my dog, yeah.
Don't forget them.
I just have one dog. A border collie. Her name is Nala. I always talk about her. She's so beautiful. I miss my family a lot. My friends, too. So I feel like that's why I keep going back every time I'm on break. Like, even now.
Are you going home for Thanksgiving?
Yeah. Oh, not for Thanksgiving. We don't celebrate Thanksgiving, obviously. But it's too, like, the break is too short, and, like, you want to, like, make
maximize
worth it, because it's pretty expensive after all. But I'm definitely going to go back for Christmas, like, the last day of school here, I'm going back to Luxembourg, and I come back on the last day of break.
Okay.
So, yeah, I want to make the most of it, see my family, and enjoy the time with them.
And I'm sure you're looking forward to that.
Always. I love Christmas time anyway. And with the family, it's so important. I have to cherish that.
So if you're now joining us, we are chatting. It's just a nice chat today with Diane. Diane is a very close friend of mine. And she's an international student here at Pace University studying psychology. And Diane is from Luxembourg. So you're listening to some music from Diane's playlist. And as you enjoy it, when we return, we will talk about the playlist, actually.
On y croit ou pas, y aura bien un jour où on n'y croira plus. Un jour ou l'autre, on sera tous papa, et d'un jour à l'autre, on aura disparu. Serons-nous détestables? Serons-nous admirables? Des géniteurs ou des génies? Dites-nous qui donne naissance aux irresponsables? Hein? Dites-nous qui? Tiens, tout le monde sait comment on fait des bébés, mais personne sait comment on fait des papas. Monsieur, je sais tout, on aurait hérité, c'est ça, faut le sucer de son pouce ou quoi? Dites-nous où c'est caché, ça doit.
I want to say good afternoon to everyone who is watching us on Facebook Live. Hello to Mike and Kiana and my sister Deborah all the way in Guyana. Thank you for watching. And I want to say hello to Jan, who just said, Diane, you have impeccable taste in music.
Oh, thank you.
And hello to Soraya, who said that she knows some of the music that we're listening to. I think I may be pronouncing her name wrong, but okay, thank you for watching. And Ebony, thank you for watching. Alexis, hello. Hi, Patrick. Haslin, hello. Roland, hi. Ryan, hi. Roger, good afternoon. We hope that you're having a great day wherever you're listening, wherever you're watching. Hi, Seanette, if you are watching from Maryland or Luxembourg or Guyana or New York or New Jersey, wherever you are watching on live or listening on the radio, we thank you so much for joining us. If you're now joining us, this is the International Experience. I'm your host, Tandika. And every Tuesday, we're here from 12 to 1 p.m. just chatting with international students and persons who work in services here at Pace University, supporting our international student population. And Diane is from Luxembourg,
yes.
And she has shared some of her music with us, and I like this one. It has a nice little catch to it.
Yeah, it's very catchy. I love the song, too. It's kind of sad, though, like the meaning behind
what
it.
What is he saying?
He's, so...
Let me know so I can stop dancing.
So basically what he says is Papa Ute, which means...
Is
Dad,
this
where
French?
Are you?
Or...
Yes, this is French.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, Dad, where are you? So it's basically about dads giving up on their children.
Aww.
So, yeah. I know it's a very catchy rhythm, but it's a sad meaning behind it.
No, I have to stop dancing.
Yeah, you see? I'm sorry, I spoiled it, but yeah.
Well, let's talk some more about the songs you selected on the list.
Okay. So, I told you before I had a fun time putting this playlist together. A couple of these songs, I haven't heard them in a long time. So I told my family I was going to do this radio show with you, and they bombarded me with with songs on Spotify, and I was like, okay, I don't know what to choose from. I don't even know these songs, but then I like, because I just, like at home, we would always listen to the radio, and you know, you just listen to the radio, you don't know the name of the song or like who's singing it. So I was like starting to listen to them. I was like, oh my gosh, I know all of these songs, and I just get really nostalgic. And I was like, oh my gosh,
yeah.
It reminds me of my childhood. So yeah, so they're French, German. There's a couple of Luxembourgish ones, like not many because yeah, like I said before, it's hard to find Luxembourgish music. Even on the Luxembourgish radio, like when you listen to our local radio, we mainly play, well, American hits, hits from the UK, many from Germany that I put in here, French ones, Luxembourgish a couple, but like they don't really play them that much either because there's not that many out there. I don't think that we've gotten to one yet. I think this one is called like Luxembourg City or something. Yeah, I don't know. There's not many, but yeah, honestly, Luxembourgish people, they grow up listening to French, German, English music as well, which I feel like is the reason why we learn English pretty fast. I don't know if that's that, but yeah, I had a good time putting it together. It reminded me of my childhood, and yeah, thank you to my sister who sent me so many songs, and I put most of them in there.
Okay. Hello to Diane's sister listening
Celine.
To us. Celine.
Yes.
Hello, Celine, listening to
yes.
us from Luxembourg. Hello, Anna, who's listening to us from Keene. We
Yay,
love you.
Anna, we love you.
So let's talk some more about here, you coming here to the U.S., mm-hmm. and now you're settled in New York. Have you traveled anywhere else outside of
yes.
New Jersey and New York? And what is your general impression of other places that you visited here in the U.S.?
So I went to Chicago. Like, that was, I think, my first year that I was here.
Mm-hmm. It's cold there.
Oh, my. I was there
Did
this
you
summer.
Go, oh, bless
yes.
the Lord.
Yes, yes. I was there in the summer. I was doing fine. But, yeah, I really enjoyed Chicago, actually. It's also very diverse, I would say. It's a big city. It's definitely cleaner than New York. I noticed that there's not so much trash on the streets, but I don't know, New York is still my number one. I enjoyed that. Then I also went down to Florida, I went to Miami, and I went to Orlando. It's nice, it's warm, but it's just not really my thing.
Mm-hmm.
I went there in December, and I went there once in December and once in like the spring, but like that it's warm in December, I've never done that before. I think it's very weird. And I got really sick when I came back because I just couldn't make the difference of like warm and then suddenly really cold, because here in New York it gets freezing cold
in December. Yeah,
yes.
Then you can, then you wouldn't be able to visit Guyana. It's always warm.
I guess it's all a thing of like getting used to, but I was just like, oh my gosh, I can't do this.
But I understand getting sick, because mm-hmm. the first time I came here from Guyana was the summertime.
Mm-hmm.
So I came at the end of summer when the weather is beginning to change. So yeah. It's like there's a chill but there's still sun out. And I just came from like this really warm weather back home, and I came here and I got sick.
Yeah.
I was sick for weeks, so I completely understand.
You really have to get used to the transition of the weather.
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like it's also when it changes from season to season. Mm-hmm. Like sometimes here, there's no like in between. There's no fall. Like it's warm. Like even now, it's not that cold out.
No.
Yet. It's like.
I'm wearing like a raincoat today only because it's raining. Yeah.
It's raining, but it's not cold. So it's gonna, I know it's gonna come from one day to the other. It's gonna be freezing cold, and that's when I'm gonna get sick. It's like this sudden change. Like even when it got hot here, because it gets hot and humid in New York.
Yeah.
It's not just warm. I got really sick because then they blast the air conditioning everywhere. I can't handle the air conditioning here. What is that? Like I don't understand. It's
so
freezing.
I have a some time ago I read somewhere that the air conditioning is set in buildings to accommodate the male body. So I read that somewhere. I can't remember where I saw that article. Uh-huh. But basically the air conditioning is set to accommodate the male body.
Uh-huh.
So that's why it's as cold for us. But for them it's like, oh, what are you talking about?
They're still sweating too.
Yes.
Oh my gosh. Like I see guys on the subway, like bald guys, and they're still like they're sweating from their naked heads. It's like it's not pretty. Like I'm freezing. I'm like in my little dress and I'm so cold and they're just like sweating. And yeah, I don't get that.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I feel like I got used to the air conditioning by now, but in the beginning I had a hard time.
Yeah. Everything is a transition.
Everything.
So we're talking about Luxembourgish music. What do you miss in terms of food in Luxembourg that you can't get here?
Okay.
Tell us about the Luxembourg meal.
Okay. So let me just say I was in the Luxembourgish Scouts, which is different from American Scouts. Like here you have Girl Scouts and Boy Scouts, and Girl Scouts, they go and sell cookies, which we never did, thankfully. We were mixed and we had a good time together. We went camping and all that. And I feel like that's where I learned about Luxembourgish food.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, my home is French and German. We didn't really eat Luxembourgish. We never went out to eat Luxembourgish. So there's something called, like my favorite, I guess, it's Knödeln.
What is that?
It sounds so cute.
Is that a dessert, a main dish, an appetizer?
It's really, so Luxembourgish food is definitely very heavy, which is probably why I don't really eat it. I can't with heavy food. But it's kind of like, I don't know what to like compare it to. Maybe a mixture of potato and noodles. I don't know. Like it's very easy to make it with like flour and milk, and you eat it with bacon and apple, like what do you call it? Apple mousse.
Okay.
Yeah, and that's like a whole meal. It's a thing. Yeah, that was my favorite. We do have an own version of French toast called pain perdu, which is like a big thing in Luxembourg. I think it's French though too, I don't even know. But yeah, there were like a couple of fun things that we ate. Bonne schloop, which is like, it sounds really, really bad, but it's like a soup kind of thing with beans, also very heavy, obviously because beans are included.
Yeah.
Then there's Krumpere Kichelche, which is potatoes, like fried together, and it's really good. I like that. Like lots of stuff with potatoes,
yeah.
I would say.
And there is no like restaurant or Luxembourgish restaurant
yes,
in New
there
York.
Is. Oh, in New York. I don't think so. I have never looked it up. I'm not craving it. I've been craving French food, I guess. I love the way the French cook. It's like I love the desserts.
I know you love to make crepes.
Crepes, exactly.
Yes.
Yeah, that's my favorite.
I know I've had your crepes before.
That's right, like every event we had.
Every event we had
in school.
Diane would be like, I'm gonna break.
Because it's so easy to make, and I was like, oh my crepes. And it's basically like pancakes, it's just like much thinner. But you liked them, okay?
I did.
It's a thing.
They were delicious, Diane.
Thank you.
If you are now joining us, you're listening to the International Experience. Hi, Terry.
Terry's
joining us on live. If we're listening to the International Experience, and I'm just having a light chat today with my friend Diane. Diane is from Luxembourg. And the music you are listening to is Luxembourgish and French and German music, which are all three languages spoken in Luxembourg. And so we're going to take a break as you enjoy some music, and then when we come back, we chat some more with Diane. So just to talk a little about some events that are happening here, PACE are being organized by students here at PACE. There's going to be a Casino Royale Masquerade Ball to benefit domestic violence, and that's going to be on November 1 at Big Deal Casino on 5th Avenue, 6th floor, New York. And tickets range between $75 to $200. And you can find tickets on Eventbrite. I actually was asked to promote this by Professor Varese Cooper. So if you know Varese, just find him and ask him about the details of how they can purchase tickets and all that fun stuff. But there's going to be cocktails, hors d'oeuvres, silent auction, casino games, and more. Speaking of events, today is October 29th, and the much anticipated PACE Talks is taking place tonight, which is our version of a TED Talk, and I'm one of the six student speakers that will be speaking this evening. It's going to be at 7 p.m. in the Student Center at One Place PACE Plaza here at PACE University. So if you have the time to join us tonight, it's going to be fun. There's going to be swag surfing. They're going to be giving away good stuff. It's going to be a fun time. And then you're going to see six students talk about authenticity. So join us tonight if you have the time after class. Event starts at 7, and we would love to have you. Ich machte es ein Recht, alle sollten mich lieben, sag ich, die Dämonen, die mich dazu trieben, war gefangen und nicht mehr frei. Und ich ging kaputt dabei. Man kann die Welt nicht ewig wenden, ich muss den Quatsch sofort beenden. Denn du bist immer dran, am besten, wenn's dir eigentlich egal ist. Du bist immer dran. As we continue to talk about activities, I need to talk about some of the activities available here on campus for international students. The International Students and Scholars Office will be having their weekly tea and coffee hour. That's on October 31st. It's every Thursday. This week it's going to be Halloween themed, and they encourage you to come in your Halloween costumes. It's at 163 William Street on the 16th floor. All your favorite candies will be served. So if you don't have the time to go trick-or-treating in the evening, this is the perfect opportunity for you to come with your Halloween costume and I guess get some treats. I don't know about tricking.
Sounds fun.
The International Student Club, the Taiwanese Association, and Sabor Latina, Urban Sound, and Hata, they're having a Fright Night party also on Halloween night. That's the 31st from 7 to 11 p.m. at the Student Center. You can contact anyone from one of those clubs to find out how you can attend the party. And it sounds like it's going to be fun. And of course, you know, always check out activities. There's lots of activities happening in New York City every day. I always say that one of the things that I did when I first got here as an international student, every week or weekend, I would try to explore a different aspect of New York. There's so much to find. There's like free museums that you can attend.
Lots of free stuff.
Lots of free stuff. And I know a lot of international students have faced, you don't read the emails that are being sent out by the ISS office, but at the very bottom of the email, they send you a list of things that you can check out to do in New York. So guys, read the emails, okay? If you're not joining us, you're listening to The International Experience. I'm your host, Tandika, and we're here every Tuesday from 12 to 1 p.m. We stream on WPUB.org, and every week we feature a different student to talk about their culture and their experience here at Pace and about being an international student in the whole. And today we're chatting with Diane, and you're listening to some of her music. Diane is from Luxembourg, and in Luxembourg they speak English, French, sorry, which is another question I should ask you. How did you learn to speak English?
Well, we have English classes. I think they started in around 8th grade or something. So yeah, we learned the grammar and all that stuff until like we graduate. But speaking is a whole other thing. So coming here definitely helped that. And I didn't have anyone here who spoke my language, except for actually my host family. It was funny. My host family, they were French and German as well. Mm-hmm. But like every time I went out with like my friends, like nobody spoke French or German. So I was forced to speak English, which honestly helps you a lot. And yeah, that's how I got around to learning English. But honestly, I feel English is such a universal language, and in Luxembourg, like, it's a big bank country, and there's lots of business people coming in and out, so English is also something that everybody kind of speaks eventually. Kids, not so much, but like, once you grow up, that's definitely a language that everybody gets to speaking as well.
Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So yeah, so in Luxembourg they speak French, German, and Luxembourgish.
Yay.
But they're taught English at school.
Yes.
So Diana, let's talk some more about your experience here at Pace. So actually, you're the person who made me aware about Pace University.
That's right? Yeah.
Yeah, we had this conversation and you told me you got accepted to Pace, and I was like, you know, I'm looking to do something else. So and you were like, yeah, check it out, this is a good option. And then here we are.
Here we are. that was what, like, not even 2 years ago.
No.
We were like, yeah, I graduated from
it was
K last year.
It was 2016, I believe, when I graduated. Or was
no,
it now?
2018.
It was last year?
I graduated last year from my bachelor's, and now I'm already here, and I'm almost done with my master's. It's insane. So are you.
Yeah.
Because we started together,
yeah,
and now we finished together.
Do so you graduate awesome. In May?
Yes.
So we walk together. Yay!
It's going to be fun.
It's going to be fun.
Yes.
So, since we're talking about Pace now, to kind of bring it home to Pace University, how do you think that your experience here at Pace has been preparing you, or has not been preparing you, for post-graduation, finding work, or even in the process of finding internships and that kind of thing? How has Pace been helpful in doing that?
I honestly feel like Pace has given me nothing but opportunities. Like, it's been very, very helpful. Maybe because of the location, because in New York, honestly, there's so many more internship opportunities than in Jersey, I would say. As I said before, I got the opportunity to work at the UN, which I obviously think is part of the location. I mean, the UN is located, the headquarters are located in New York. So that was definitely helpful, and I had a great experience. I got to know many interesting people, and also my mentor for my thesis now, and she has been amazing and a big part of my whole school life here, and has mentored me through everything. And now I may have the opportunity to present my thesis at a conference in Boston next year.
That's exciting.
Yes, I'm so excited for that. So I'm honestly, I feel like Pace and New York, both, the combination of it has set me up for success in that way. And I'm not really worried that, I mean, I'm not going to say, yeah, I'm going to get out of here and like get the best job right away. Not at all. But it's definitely taught me to fight for what I want.
I feel like the whole New York City scene, and especially Pace, the opportunities are so limitless. Like, I never thought that coming to pace. I figured I'm just gonna come. I'm just gonna do my program of study and mm-hmm. whatever, mm-hmm. you know, work as a grad assistant or whatever. But here I am, on doing this show. Like, there's so many opportunities available to mm-hmm. students, and it's not limited to students who are from the U.S. or whatever. It's very international,
very diverse, and I've been really enjoy. I mean, I'm kind of in the international club. I mean, I was very invested, and obviously, since we were working in the international office at Kane back in Jersey, I was also president of the international club there. Like, I was very invested in that. But coming here, maybe not being part of all that, I still feel very included. I've never had any issues with that. But that's a New York thing too. New York is extremely diverse, and coming from a diverse country anyway, I feel so at home here because I love it that people are speaking several languages or different languages for me. I don't mind like listening to other languages, not knowing what it means. Like, I'm used to that. That's fine. I love getting to know other cultures. Like, we come from two so different cultures, and I love talking to you because it's so interesting, you know. Obviously, it's always nice when you get to know someone who's from your country so you can kind of like share your experience and all that. But honestly, I don't think I have any French or German friends here. They're all from different countries.
Which is probably a good thing, you know, to expand your horizons and
get
to know.
I go home, I can see them there, and I'm very happy to see them there. So here I hang out with people from all over the world, honestly. That's the thing. When I go to a party in New York, people are not going to be from America. I mean, they are, maybe, but like, I meet people from all over the world.
Oh, yeah.
I love that.
I love that too. That's one of the things I love most about New York mm-hmm. and about pace.
Yes.
If you are now joining us, you're listening to The International Experience. I'm your host, Tandika, and we're having a chat with Diane. Diane is from Luxembourg, and she's an international student studying psychology here at Pace University. She is doing her graduate studies, and she's a dear friend of mine. So we're listening to her music, and I hope you are enjoying it. Mathe, Junge, 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 not das Tag. Ich muss Money machen. Geboren der Minette, der GM, der zu Esch. Ja, stießen Zigarette, da kicken die der Wäsch. Ja, ried an den Ginett, ne siebe Liter Wäsch. Likite, Killa Flash, ja, Liti, Killa Flash. Ich komm zu spät und toll, weil ich der Moje beim Zoll war. An der Fall war zu viel Gold, auf Menge nur stinkt voll. War ich über der Kickoffer, Kickoffer, ich über Gold, ja. Mit meinem Koffer voller Pulver, aber eure Volt war. Du frisst dich, werde ich mal. Ich muss Money machen. Mathe, Junge, 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 not das Grad. Ich muss Money machen. Du frisst dich, werde ich mal. Ich muss Money machen. Mathe, Junge, 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 not das Grad. Ich muss Money. Ich krieg mein Cash. 300 Ball, Kaffeemeldung von der Witwe. Zank, hei am Land geht viel gespart, bla bla bla, schnell gelacht, ha ha ha. Mit der Hut an ihrem Leben noch nie abgeskürt, ne, ich brauch mal, ne, schon seit der Kant, ne, seit der Kant, ne, du bist die Lamme, wie ich die Vokal, ne, mein, wieder gingen nach dem Fickbauer von einem Schiebe, es bitte neues, so ein Kleid, Schiebe, R, U, C, E, ich muss Money machen, du willst kein dein CD, und du frisst dich, werde ich mal. Ich muss Money machen. Mathe, Junge, 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 noch das Draht. Ich muss Money machen. Ando, frisst dich, werde ich mal. Ich muss Money machen. Mathe, Junge, 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 noch das Draht. I want to say good afternoon to everyone listening to us all over the world, in Guyana, Atlanta, here in New York, New Jersey. Shout out to everyone in the Lubin School of Business. All of my friends there, Matricia, Tamara, she, Rebecca, who's going to be on the show in a few weeks. Rebecca is from Austria.
Ooh.
So we're going to have Rebecca on sometime in November to talk about the Austrian culture. So it's going to be an exciting show. Coming up also later on in November, we're going to have Luana on the show, Pereira. Luana is originally from Brazil, and I met Luana while I was a student at Kane. She's a former student at Kane. And now Luana is doing some amazing things, working with all sorts of students, helping them to prepare for work. So we're going to be talking about all of that and what Luann is doing. And that's later in November. So we have some exciting guests coming up on the show. And I hope you will join us every Tuesday from 12 to 1. Remember, we are live at WPUB.org. You can listen on your cell phone, on your laptop, whatever you're doing, on your lunch break. Just join us. We're having a nice little dance party with music from different cultures. And we're just having a nice chat with our guests. So today, Diane is joining us. Diane, you know I have to ask you this because we're friends.
That's very fun.
And we're single lady. Well,
we're single ladies.
Single.
Ladies. Oh, yeah,
quote
yeah.
unquote single lady.
Whatever that means.
That statement might get me in trouble later. But anyway.
Oh, gosh. Be careful.
What is it like dating in New York?
Oh my God. Honestly, people like New Yorkers are so open and like they're so chill. They're like, oh, okay, I like you, let's go out, you know? And like it's definitely nice. And you're a little, I mean, I was at least a little overwhelmed in the beginning. I was like, wait, what? You know, take a step back. I don't even know you, and you're just like randomly asking. But yeah, I don't know, it's a nice way to get to know people. You don't need Tinder here. People, like, they just come up to you and ask you. Don't worry about that. Yeah, so it's been interesting. I'm still single. I'm still enjoying my alone time. Yeah, and I'm not... this is so funny. I'm not looking for anything serious right now, okay? So just making that clear.
Gentlemen, yeah. You heard it first. The beautiful Diane.
Sometimes
is single
to,
and ready to mingle.
No, that's what I'm saying. You have to make that very clear. It's like, people, not now. No, it's a good time. I've met great guys, all very respectful. Like,
yeah.
Nobody's been annoying or anything, respecting my decision to still be alone.
You do meet. It's a fun time. I met a lot of nice people. And one time I met a really nice guy on the train here in New York. He was very nice. Yeah.
That's good. Yeah. You meet people on the subway.
On the subway.
Everywhere. Yeah. Like, could be anyone, anywhere, anytime.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I like that. I like that you're just all here having a fun time. And this is what this show is about. It's about talking about the fun times and the not so fun times.
Yeah.
That we have as international students. So I must ask you, what has been your most memorable experience as an international student? And what has been the most challenging time that you've had so far?
I mean, as to my most challenging time, as I referred to before, my first semester in undergrad, that was really hard because I didn't understand the whole school system. The education system is completely different. I've never been to university in Europe, so what do I know? But like from what I heard, you know, it's very different. I didn't get the whole credit thing, and I don't know, it was just a mess the first semester, so that was very challenging. The most memorable, I feel like there's been so many memorable times. I always think back to, honestly, the time that we were all together at the office.
I know, CIS fam, we need to have a Friendsgiving.
It warms my heart thinking about that. Like, I loved going to work, no matter like what annoying people came in sometimes, you know, it was like, it was the best time. And like I said, it was like that strong support system that got me through a lot, So that was definitely amazing. I don't know. I feel like just being on the subway can be very memorable. I've seen crazy things.
Micro moments. That's something I'm just learning in my social media class.
Yeah.
They're all micro moments.
They're micro
moments that lead to a bigger aha moment and a greater experience.
Oh, I like that. Yeah, I feel like, now we're talking about the subway again, but I don't know, I've seen interesting things, especially like, again, rush hour. We were all pressed into the train like sardines, and the people, they still try to get in though, even though they know there's no space. This one guy.
I'm guilty of that, so I'm not going to comment.
Me too. Everybody is, because you just want to get home at some point, or you're like rushing somewhere else. There's no time, you know? So this one guy tried to squeeze in, and that guy was already standing in, he turned around and pushed him outside, was like, don't you get up so close to me. And he was like, he was really pissed, and it was like the most hilarious thing. And they were about to start fighting when the door closed.
Yeah, New Yorkers can be very aggressive.
Yeah, but there's a reason for it. Honestly, I kind of get it now that I live here. especially like tourists can be very obnoxious. Like we PACE is located in Faidai Financial District. So the Brooklyn Bridge is really close.
Yeah, there are a lot of tourists around here.
Oh my gosh. And just like me trying to run an errand during lunch break makes me crazy sometimes, because the tourists, they just stop in the middle of the street and you bump into them, then they get upset, and I'm like, well, you're not moving, you know, like you know me, I'm a very nice person usually, but then even I get really upset and I'm like, dude, move, you know, like whatever. Like that's what it's like to be a New Yorker, though, you know. You're just raw and real, and people are going to be very honest with you here, so you have to expect that coming here.
This is the New York experience. So you're listening to some Luxembourg music from Luxembourg, French, German, and Luxembourgish music that Diane has curated especially for this show today. So enjoy this music, and when we come back, we chat some more with Diane just to close off the show. I want to say good afternoon to everyone who's joined us on Facebook Live today. We appreciate you for watching. Remember, you can also stream us on WPUB.org from 12 to 1 p.m. every Tuesday. You can listen on your laptop or on your cell phone. Well, we thank you for listening and watching wherever you do so. It's a great day here. It's raining, but you know what? We're just having some fun in the studio. It's warming up.
How would we know? There's no windows. Whatever. We're just having a good time.
It was raining when we came in, Diane.
Whatever. Like, yeah.
You're forgetting I came from across the street. You didn't leave the building.
I did not leave the building. I just came up, took the elevator up. Yeah.
It is so convenient for you that the radio suit station is in your building.
Yeah, very convenient.
I had to run across the plaza.
It's not that far, okay?
In the rain. But we're having a good time. So, Diane.
Yes.
Before you leave us today, we're so grateful that you came on the show. This was such a fun time. I missed you. I've missed hanging out with you. We need to fix that. We need to have lunch again sometime soon. Anything else you want to share with our listeners today about your overall, or if you can put your overall experience as an international student into one or a few words, how would you sum it up?
I feel like there's probably 1,000 words that you could sum up being an international student. I'm just going to choose that it's very rewarding. It's teaching you to be persistent, you know, to, like I said, didn't like my first semester here, it doesn't matter, you just gotta push through sometimes, you know, and it's gonna, like I said, we come such a long way from here, you being forced to come out of your shell and to meet new people all the time, live in a country, in a culture that you don't know, and I mean, it's worked out great for me. It doesn't always work great for everyone, but I mean, we've worked in an international office and we've seen all sorts of students
and heard all kinds of stories. Yeah.
All kinds of stories. Bad stories, but then also really good stories. Yeah. And then all the American students who went to study abroad always came back
with
a positive experience, right? I mean, you know, you work like one-on-one with them. So it's honestly, yes, it sounds scary at first. It really does. Well, shout out to my sister again. She just did an internship in Barcelona this year.
Oh, good for her.
Yes. And it was 6 months, which is quite some time, because she's always been close to home, so she wasn't really used to this whole being away for so long. But she loved it. And then also they were speaking a language there she didn't know. She's still not a fluent Spanish speaker, but she made it work, and she really grew from that. So I'm so proud of her. So honestly, I can just recommend it to anyone. If you're from New York and you want to study abroad somewhere, please just do it. Don't even think about it twice. It's very rewarding. And yeah, anyone listening from Europe right now, come to America sometime. I like to show you around in New York. It's fun. It's a good time. I don't know what else to add. maybe, oh, like your list of questions that you sent me beforehand. There was this thing about a rumor, like a myth.
A myth, yes.
About my country.
Is there a myth?
I think there's several. I mean, I don't know if that's a myth, but people, they always think that people in Luxembourg are rich because it's a, like, I think it's the second richest country in the world or something. Yeah, it's great. And we have great opportunities. We have free transportation, for example. But it doesn't mean that the people are rich.
So you're not rich, Diane.
No. From a very normal family, like very down to earth and balanced, and I just want to like clear that up. Also, we're not, like I said, now people should, listeners should know by now that Luxembourg is a country, it's not part of Germany. How many people here are asking me, oh, Luxembourg, I know Luxembourg, it's part of Germany, right? I'm like, no. Sorry, we're a country, you know, it's very small, but we're still a country.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's something I wanted to clear up, I think. Is there something else? Oh yeah, Luxembourgish is a real language. That's also a thing. I don't know if you would call it Luxembourgish in English, but I just do. I guess that's how you say it. Mm-hmm. It is a language. Luxembourgish people are going to get offended if you tell them it's not. So yeah, it's an independent language. So when people ask me how many languages do you speak, I say it's four.
Four. English. Yeah, English. Yeah.
So it's English, French, German, and Luxembourg.
Oh, thank you so much, Diane. And thank you for being on the show today. And
I loved it. It was so fun.
That's all the time we have today. Time went by so quickly. Time flies when you're having fun.
For sure.
And we want to thank Diane for being on the show today. We want to thank everyone who listened to us online and everyone who joined us on Facebook Live. Whatever you do today, just be kind and have a great day.
Thank you.